Dear students, welcome to my next session. In today's class, I will be discussing on the next topic, differential equations of first order and higher degree. A differential equation of the first order and nth degree of the first order and the nth degree is of the form is of the form p power n plus a1 p power n minus 1 plus a2 p power n minus 2 plus etc. plus an minus 1 into p plus an equal to 0 plus an equal to 0. The differential equation of the first order and nth degree is of this form in general, where p is dy by dx and a's are functions of x and y, and a1 a2 a3 are simply a's are functions of x and y, functions of x and y. In several cases, this equation 1 is reduced to first order ordinary differential equation and then solved. In several cases, equation one can be solved by reducing a into one or more equations of first order by reducing it into one or more equations of first order and first degree there are 3 to 4 cases prescribed in your syllabus. First one is solvable for p, then solvable for x, then equation solvable for y, and Clairaut's equation. Let us take one by one. Equations solvable for P. As the first case, we shall take equations solvable for P. Now, resolving LHS of 1. Resolving left hand side of 1 into n linear factors into n linear factors into n linear factors, we get P minus F1 of x comma y into P minus F2 of x comma y into P minus F3 of x comma y into P minus F3 of x comma y, etc. into P minus Fn of x comma y equal to 0. Okay. So one can reduce the LHS of 1 into product of factors like this. So this gives P minus F1 of x comma y equal to 0 or P minus F2 of x comma y equal to 0, P minus F3 of x comma y equal to 0, etc. P minus Fn comma x comma y, Fn of x comma y equal to 0. If we solve these equations independently and obtain the solutions like if F1 of x comma y comma c equal to 0 comma F2 of x comma y comma c equal to 0 F3 of x comma y comma c equal to 0, etc. Fn comma x comma y comma c equal to 0 are the solutions of these equations respectively, are the solutions of these n equations respectively, that means F1 of x comma y comma c, the solution of P minus F1 of x comma y equal to 0, similarly F2 solution of this, F3 solution of this, and Fn of x comma y comma c equal to 0, solution of this. If these are the solutions of these equations respectively, then the general solution of one, the given equation
is
F1 of x comma y comma c. F1 of x comma y comma c into F2 of x comma y comma c into F3 of x comma y comma c into etc. Fn of x comma y comma c equal to 0. So this is the general solution of the equation 1 by solving for p. Now let me consider an example. For example, solve x squared into dy by dx whole squared plus x into y dy by dx minus 6 into y squared equal to 0 by solving for p. So we know that p is dy by dx. So therefore this equation can be written as x square p square plus x into y p minus 6y square equal to 0. So given the equation, is x square dy by dx whole square plus x into y dy by dx minus 6 into y square equal to 0. But p is dy by dx, so therefore x square p square plus xy into p minus 6y square equal to 0. Okay. So call this equation as 1. Now let me solve for p. So p is equal to minus x into y plus or minus square root of x square into y square minus into minus, that is plus 4 into 6, that is 24. x square y square divided by 2 into x square. Okay. Now let me simplify this. So therefore p is equal to minus x into y plus or minus square root of 24 x square y square plus x square y square is 25 x square y square. 25 x square y square, x square, y square, and divided by 2 into x square. Now further, this p can be now written as minus x into y, square root of 25 x square y square is 5xy whole square, so therefore root 25 is 5, x square is x, y square root y square is 1. So minus x into y plus or minus 5xy divided by 2 into x square. So therefore p takes the two values now, minus xy plus 5 into xy divided by 2x square. P is equal to minus xy minus 5 x into y divided by 2 into x square. Okay. Now, if you simplify, P is equal to a plus 4 x into y divided by 2x square, and in this case minus 6xy minus 6xy divided by 2 into x square. So I can simplify, you can remove 2 here and 1 x you can remove. So this is p is equal to 2y divided by x, and here p is, you can remove 1, 2 and 1 x minus 3y divided by x. Okay. So therefore, equation 1 can be written as, there is this equation, both are same, equation 1, okay. We call this as equation 1, with P, equation 1 can now be written as, can be written as P minus 2y divided by x into P plus 3y divided by x equal to 0. Okay. Like P minus f1 of x comma y into P plus f2 of x comma y equal to 0. So this gives P minus 2y by x equal to 0, or P plus 3 into 1 by x equal to 0. Now let me consider the first equation. Consider P minus 2 into y by x equal to 0. This means P is equal to 2 into y by x, but P is divided. So, but P is divided here. Therefore, dy by dx is equal to 2y by x, which is nothing but first order, first degree, ordinary differential equations. This differential equation can be solved just by applying variable separable method. So separating the variables, we have dy by y is equal to 2 into dx by x. Now once the variables are separated, the solution is integration of each side dy by y is equal to 2 into integral dx by x. So for simplicity, I will take the integral constant as log c. Okay. So integration of dy by y is log y is equal to 2 into log x plus log c, or log y is equal to log x square plus log c. Further, we can simplify still, but this can be written as log c into x square. So therefore, y is equal to c into x square, or y minus c into x square equal to 0. y minus c into x square equal to 0. So similarly, let us find the solution of another equation, another possibility. Consider consider p plus 3y divided by x equal to 0. So p is dy by dx plus 3y by x equal to 0, or dy by dx is equal to p is equal to minus 3y by x. So dy by dx is equal to minus 3 into y divided by x. Again, separating the variables, this is a first order, first degree, order differential equation, which can be solved easily by separating the variables. Separating the variables. Separating the variables, I can easily write this as dy by y is equal to minus 3 dx by x. So therefore, its solution is integration of each side dy by y is equal to minus 3 integral dx by x, so plus log c. Log c is integral constant. So integrating this, I get log y is equal to minus 3 into log x plus log c. So further, I can write this as, this can be written as log x power minus 3. Log x power minus 3 plus log c, or further you can write this as log y is equal to log c into x power minus 3. Okay. So therefore y is equal to c into x power minus 3, or y is equal to c divided by x cube, or x cube y is equal to c, or x cube y minus c equal to 0. So therefore, the general solution of y is y minus cx square into x cube minus y minus c equal to 0. Thus, the general solution of given problem y is y minus cx square into x cube into y minus c equal to 0. So this is the general solution of the given problem. Now let me consider the second example. For which quantity we have to solve solvable for P or solvable for X or solvable for Y.
Etc.
Solve X into Y P square X into Y P square minus of X square plus Y square into P plus X into Y equal to 0 by solving for P by solving for P. Then let me solve this problem. Solution: the given equation is X into Y P square X into Y P square minus of X square plus Y square into P plus XY equal to 0. X square plus Y square plus XY. So call this as equation 1. Equation 1. Okay. Solve for P. Solve for P. Then P is equal to minus of X square plus Y square, that is X square plus Y square, plus or minus square root of X square plus Y square whole square minus 4 into XY into XY minus 4 X square Y square whole thing divided by 2 into X into Y. Now let me simplify this. So P is X square plus Y square plus or minus square root of. So if you expand this, you get X power 4 plus Y power 4 plus 2 into X square Y square minus 4 x square y square. Okay. And then divided by 2 into x into y. Now, P, we further simplify X square plus Y square plus or minus square root of X power 4 plus Y power 4 plus 2X square Y square minus 4X square Y square minus 2X square Y square divided by 2 into X into Y. Okay. Further, I can write this as X square plus Y square, X square minus Y square, whole square. So P further can be written as X square plus Y square plus square root of X square minus Y square, the whole square divided by 2 into X into Y. Further, can rewrite this as X square plus Y square plus or minus X square minus Y square divided by 2 into X into Y. Therefore, this can be written as, so therefore P is equal to X square plus y square plus x square minus y square divided by 2 into x into y, then p, another value, is x square plus y square minus of x square minus y square divided by 2 into
x into y.
Okay. Further, this is equal to, so y square can cancel. So you have 2x square divided by 2 into x into y, and in this case p, x square can cancel. So y square plus y square, that is 2 into y square divided by 2 into
x into y.
Now simplify, 2 2 you can cancel, 1 x you can cancel. So therefore p is equal to x by y, and in this case you can cancel 2 and 1 y can cancel y by x. So therefore 1 can be written as, 1 can be written as p minus x by y into p minus y by x equal to 0. This gives, p minus x by y equal to 0, p minus y by x equal to 0. Let us consider one by one. Consider p minus x divided by y equal to 0. So therefore dy by dx minus x by y equal to 0, because p is dy by dx. So therefore this can be written as dy by dx is equal to x divided by
y.
So this is the first order ordinary differential equation of first degree, and this can be solved by separating the variables. Separating the variables, we have y into dy is equal to
x into dx.
So once the variables are separated, its solution is integration of each side, y dy is equal to x dx plus
internal constant c.
Integration of y with respect to y is y square by 2. Integration of x with respect to x, x square by 2 plus c, or multiply throughout by 2, y square is equal to x square plus 2c, or y square minus x square minus 2c is equal to 0. Solution of this equation. Similarly, consider another possibility. Consider p minus y by x equal to 0. Therefore, dy by dx is equal to y by x. Again, this is an ordinary differential equation of first order and first degree, which can be solved by separating the variables. So separating the variables, separating the variables we obtain dy by y is equal to dx by x. The variables are separated, therefore its solution is dy by y is equal to dx by x plus internal constant. I will take it as log c. So integration of dy by y is log y, integration of dx by x log x plus log c. So therefore log y is equal to log c into x, log c into x, therefore y is equal to c into x, or y minus c into x equal to 0, which is the solution of p minus y by x equal to 0. So therefore the general solution, solution of given differential equation 1 is y square minus x square minus 2c into y minus cx equal to 0. Consider another example on equations solvable for p. Third example, solve pq. Solve pq plus 2x into p square. 2x into p square minus y square p square minus 2x y square p equal to 0 by solving for x. Solution. The given equation is pq plus 2x into p square minus y square p square minus 2x y square p equal to 0. Call this as equation 1. Now, as you observe, p is common throughout. Therefore, this can be written as p into p square plus 2x p minus y square p minus 2x y square equal to 0. So, p as a common factor, I have taken it outside. Now, I can take p outside from these two terms as a common factor. So p into p plus 2x. Similarly, I can take y square minus y square outside from these two terms. So I get p plus 2x equal to 0. So this means p minus y square into p plus 2x. So that means, so this is p into p plus 2x, p plus 2x into p minus y square equal to 0. Okay. Now this gives this gives P is equal to 0, one equation, P plus 2x equal to 0, second equation, and P minus y square equal to 0, third equation. Now let me consider one by one. P is equal to, consider P equal to 0. Consider P equal to 0. So P equal to 0 means dy by dx is equal to 0. Therefore, dy by dx equal to 0. That means y is equal to constant. Therefore, y is equal to c. So, y is equal to c or y minus c equal to 0. Okay. Next, consider another equation. Need not be harder. P plus 2x equal to 0. Now consider P plus 2x equal to 0. So therefore, dy by dx plus 2x equal to 0. Or this can be written as, this is a first order differential equation which can be solved easily by separating the variables. So this can be written as dy by dx is equal to minus 2x. So therefore separating the variables, separating the variables, separating the variables, we have dy is equal to minus 2x dx. Minus 2x dx. So therefore, the solution is integration of each side dy is minus 2x dx plus some constant c. Integration of dy is y minus 2, integration of x is x squared by 2 plus c. Or this is y is equal to minus x square plus c, or this is y plus x square minus c equal to 0. Okay. Now consider the third case. Consider the next case. P minus y square equal to 0. P minus y square equal to 0. Okay. That means, therefore, dy by dx minus y square equal to 0. So this is the order differential equation of first order and first degree. Solved easily by separating the variables. So this can be done as dy by dx is equal to y square by separating the variables. Separating the variables, dy by y square is equal to dx. So therefore, its solution is integration of each side. Dy by y square is equal to dx plus integral constant c. Integration of 1 by y square is minus 1 by y minus 1 by y. It is y power minus 2. So y power minus 2 plus 1 is minus 1. Y power minus 1 by minus 1 is minus 1 by y is equal to x plus c r multiplied by y throughout r minus 1 is equal to x into y plus c into y r x into y plus c into y plus 1 equal to 0. So therefore, thus the general solution, thus the general solution of given differential equation 1 is y is equal to c, first solution, that is y minus c, into second solution y plus x square minus c into x into y plus c into y plus 1 equal to 0. Equal to 0. One more example. Fourth one. So solve y into dy by dx whole square plus x minus y into dy by dx minus x equal to 0 by solving for p. So given equation is y into p square plus x minus y into p minus x equal to 0. So call this as equation number 1. Now solve for p. Solve for P. So P is equal to minus of x minus y plus or minus square root of x minus y whole square plus 4x into y divided by 2 into 1. After simplification, let me quickly do this. So P is minus of x minus y or y minus x plus or minus square root of, you can easily make out, is x square plus y square minus 2xy minus 2xy plus 4xy is plus 2xy, x square plus y square plus 2xy is x plus y the whole square. So when you take the root of x plus y the whole square, you get x plus y divided by 2. Okay. So therefore, so solving this, so p is y minus x plus y divided by 2 into y, and another value of p is y minus x minus x plus y minus x plus y divided by 2y. So therefore this is p is equal to, so minus x plus x will get cancelled, 2y, that is y is equal to p is equal to 1. Then in this case, minus 2f plus y, minus y, minus 2x. So in this case, p, second case, p minus 2x by 2y or minus x by 1. Minus x by 1. Therefore, one can be written as. Therefore, one can be written as. Can be written as. One can be written as p minus 1 into p plus x divided by y equal to 0. Now this gives p minus 1 equal to 0 and another case p plus x by 1 equal to 0. Now consider p minus 1 equal to 0. That means, therefore, dy by dx minus 1 equal to 0 or dy by dx is equal to 1. You can easily separate the variables to solve this first order equation. Dy is equal to dx. So its solution is integration of each side integral dx plus some constant c. So integration of dy is y, dx is x plus c, or y minus x minus c is equal to 0. X minus c equal to 0. Now let me consider another case. Another case p plus x by y equal to 0. Therefore, dy by dx plus x by y equal to 0. Or this can be written as dy by dx is equal to minus x divided by y. First order, ordinary differential equation. Separating the variables, separating the variables, separating the variables, we have y dy is equal to minus x dx. Therefore, its solution is integration of each side y dy is minus x dx plus integral constant c. Integration of y dy is y square by 2. Integration of x dx, that is minus x square by 2 plus c, multiply throughout by 2. So r y square is equal to minus x square plus 2c, or this is y square plus x square minus 2c equal to 0. Therefore, the general solution, thus the general solution of 1, general solution of 1, that is given differential equation is y minus x minus c into y square plus x square minus 2c equal to 0. Minus 2c equal to 0. So with this, I conclude this session. I'll continue the next topic in my next class. Thank you.